Tell me stories.
Okay. Okay. So say when? Among my people, the Cheyenne people, those who have two spirits, who embody both male and female, were once highly regarded. Because they embody both male and female, we look to them as our matchmakers. Our men could go to them and they would know what to say to a woman. Our women could go to them and they would know what to say back to that young man. They were very important people. Oftentimes, they were our medicine people. They took care of us. They were also nurses, because they were so strong they could go out to the battlefield and they could bring our injured men back safely. These people were highly regarded, highly prized in our communities. It's an important thing that we need to hang on to and to keep going in our culture and not to let go of the importance of embodying both male and female.
That is a strong statement in having two spirits, and as well as in the Zuni Pueblo community. In the earlier days, those individuals were esteemed individuals as well. They had the spirit for not only healing, guidance, leadership, and there are pictures of from early 1900s of a man that was dressed as a woman doing some weaving. They were also leaders in arts and crafts. Artistic design as such. So there's evidence that we have seen in the archives, pictures of men that dressed as women doing the artwork. And so there is a two-spirited person, individuals that have been accepted and has had this esteemed position in the community. Now, as it is, through the Western education process, those individuals are being shunned. And it's very unfortunate that is happening. As before, our communities would embrace every individual, no matter what condition, what form that they came with that embodiment. The community would embrace every child because every child is part of their life.
We would also, our women would go to war. If our women felt compelled, they could go. They could go and fight for their people. There was no, oh, you can't go because you're a woman. It was, you're given these strengths. Go. Go and protect our people. Or, if, as you, in your Zuni tradition, much in the same in our tradition, if a man dressed as a woman, he could live as a woman. A Cheyenne man could have a two-spirit wife, and he could have a straight wife, and no one looked down upon him because he was taking care of his community. He was caring for other people, and it wasn't looked down upon because, oh, this one wore a dress and shouldn't. It was, this person is esteemed because it's a community member. Like you said, every member is important.
Just as in my statement, that Iwi Chiminawa, that is of individuals valuing each other, loving each other, that everyone contributes to the well-being of the whole community.
Good job, Kirby. That flowed nicely. I'm glad we got to share those stories.
Yeah, I'm glad you started off on that one, because that's a good point, because I know my high school buddy, who was killed in Vietnam, but his brother was in that sense. He was effeminate. Mm-hmm. And yet he became a councilman, and he's a bright person, mm-hmm. a very bright individual, and he was just left as is and contributed quite a bit.
Yeah. My friend that I was telling you about was Zuni. Mm-hmm. He's a two-spirit person. They used to tease him, like, why can't I find a man like you who's straight? And but he says, you know, growing up, he said, I was always like this, and my uncles used to treat me badly.
Mm-hmm.
And they couldn't see what a special person he was. instead they had let that mainstream dictate how they would treat a child.
Exactly.
And so, you know, what a terrible thing.
And a lot of times now, in education, in the system that we're in, a lot of our children are categorized as special need individual.
Yeah. We're all special.
Yes, we are.
And we all have needs. Well, it was a pleasure working with you, Kirby.
Oh, this is a new horizon. I mean, opening of a new
opportunity.
Thing. Yes.
Do you have a master's degree?
Yes, I do. I did my doctoral work with Berkeley.
They asked me to come down and look at their ethnic studies program for a PhD. I mean, they asked me. I was like,
whoa,
that's big. I wish I could afford that.
Yeah. Well, Dr. Lily Wong Fillmore was my professor. She was a guiding force behind me. But I didn't finish it because it was
kind of expensive. Yeah, that's the thing.
7,200 per semester.
Yeah, I can't even imagine what it is
and
now.
And traveling. And it was through UNM, there's some professors that helped me too. I just couldn't hold on. Fortunately, several individuals were able to finish it. Dr. Christine Sims is one of them. She's the language program coordinator or director now. And the other